Hello everyone, welcome to my stream. I'm George. You can find me as Volquero in various Amiga forums. Welcome all to my stream. It's Friday, so it's a good opportunity to discuss about Amiga and MorphOS, and today we are going to talk about MorphOS. And to be more specific, we are going to talk about music applications. Tell me if you can hear me loud and clear, and if the video is fine for you. Hello, Liberal, welcome to the stream. Welcome, glad you're here. And as I told you on the previous stream, my plan was for today to have a look on music applications. Of course, in the previous stream, we had a look on a few of them, especially for those that are able to stream from online sources, radio stations and as such. But today we're going to see applications that you can use on your MorphOS machine to listen to mods or MP3s that you have locally on your system. And we are going to install some of them together. And yeah, everyone is fine. We just a little bit before the weekend, and here in Ireland, it seems that we are going to have a hot weekend. Because the temperature goes really up and higher and higher. So I hope that this weekend is going to be sunny. Hello, OP. Hello, Patrick. Welcome to the stream. Hello, Aris Amiga. Welcome. So today it was close that I wouldn't do that stream because before I start, I had my Windows system that I use for streaming had crashing for 3-4 times. Yeah, I hope that it will work better from now on. So let me stop the music and visit the application for music. Before we start, I would like to mention that as I test the songs I have here on my machine, some MP3 files and mod files to test with various applications. And I would like to mention that these songs are created by Frederick Motte, known as El Mobo. I used his music in older streams. I have the permission to use his music. Of course, we are not going to listen whole songs, but some parts from the start of his work. And the album that I'm going to use is Amiga Days. He has 4 or 5 albums based on only Amiga music. And he's a great composer, so pay him a visit on his Bandcamp page. And if you like his work, I will encourage you to buy it if you can and enjoy his music. OP says, I got a NACA 500 plus for my 500. Wow. I thought you said that you are not going to add any extra hardware on that. Transferring a lot of games now. Good, good. That's great. I'm going to use some of his music, so have that in mind. And if you like it, please go and buy his music and enjoy it. In the packages that you are going to get with the songs in MP3 format, he's also including the mod files, which is nice because you don't see that coming from people that frequently. So have that in mind as well. So let's see first some applications that are exclusive for MorphOS. That means I didn't find the versions for AmigaOS 3 or AmigaOS 4. So we are going to visit them first. Livelos says, did anyone try Avalanche by any chance? Just released. Yeah, I tried that on my OS 4 machine. It is really, really good. Really good. Chris Young, who develops it, is a very good developer. And you say, Livelord, that it is not working for you, crashing every time I try to add an archive. Weird. I guess you have the XAD library installed, right? I don't know why it crashes. I would say try to use the Snoop DOS to see if it looks for a library or something, and in case you can get some information from there. And yeah, if it doesn't work, I would recommend to go on his GitHub page and leave a message, an issue, open an issue, and I believe he is going to help you. Did the previous versions worked for you? Because I think that in the latest versions he added something like support for XVS library, which is for viruses, checking for viruses. So it might be something for like that. Maybe it misses that it is looking for this library. And yeah. Chris Young is a very experienced developer for Amiga, and the Avalanche is one of his latest utilities. And based on that, I would like to say that a few hours ago, 50% of the donations that I got on my Ko-fi page donated back to Chris Young and to support him for all his work that he's doing. And I don't know if you know it, Chris Young is the developer of WET, the weather application that we have for a long time in our Amigas, and also he's behind the port of NetSurf for AmigaOS 4 and AmigaOS 3. Actually, one of the ports in AmigaOS 3, because there is another one that is based on SDL. He's porting the NetSurf that uses the class action GUI. Anyway, let's move on. So I would like to show you first some exclusives that I found interesting and I would recommend to use. First of all, I would like to show you an application that is an old one. It is called SoundBankster. It is the only application of this kind for MorphOS, and actually it is an application that might be useful for people that would like to mix music and create their own collections between songs, or if they want to mix songs while playing for an audience or something. I don't know if anyone actually used this application for something like that. But I would like to show you that because it is an interesting app. It has a full screen mode here, and you can say that I have a list of songs here, and you can double click on the first, double click on the second song. First it loads the first song, and then you see the graph of the sound here, and then we can say we can load the second one underneath, and you can mix between the two. And there are also real-time effects, and you can do real-time repeats of blocks of songs. Let me add this one. A second. Okay. Yeah. As soon as it loads here, it loads the second one. So you can move the sound, the song at the place that you want. You can click at the top and find a place faster. And you can also click here to play it. Let me. And you can say that I want to change the phase. As you can see, those filters are applied to the song in real time, which is a good time. I don't know, is the sound of the music good enough? Like that. Okay, so and you can start a second song as well. And do things like that. Of course, as I told you on other streams, I'm not a musician. I don't know too much on how to mix songs or create my own music. I just see what exactly those applications can do, and that's what I'm presenting you here. For example, you can come and play a song and then loop some blocks. If you see there are some vertical green lines, and the songs are splitted in blocks. Every block of them, you can go and select here how many blocks you want to repeat. So right now I repeat 4 blocks. If I want, I can click on 16. And then it returns 16 blocks back and repeats that. Or you can go with 8 or anything. The funny thing is to go with that. But of course, people like DJ Hoffman or Ravi are better to discuss with you on how you can mix music and things like that. And also there is a way to apply filters here and also change the tempo. Go faster or slower. And there are also points that you can set as in a queue. So you can say that, if I understand that correct, that in this song I want first to play this part and then jump to another part, and things like that. And yeah, it's pretty useful. As I said, I don't know if anyone is using this actively. The latest version that was released, I think it was back in 2016, but it's a unique application for the Amiga ecosystem, and I believe it is a good application to give it a try if you are interested on mixing music on your system. And that's SoundBankster. And all the applications that I'm going to show you today can be found in MorphOS Storage. You can find them in morphos-storage.net. If you search here, you can find the application and download and use it. Yes, Livelord, it's for DJs. I'm not a DJ. So yeah, it's pretty good. So all the applications can be found here, and SoundBankster is a unique application and exclusive for MorphOS. One of the developers of SoundBankster is Jacek, who develops the Wayfarer, and yeah. And the next one that I would like to show you exclusive for MorphOS is bePlayer. This is developed by bWorld. It's a minimalistic player. This is based on SDL, so to use it you need to have the SDL libraries installed, and I would propose you to install the latest versions of the libraries. Falcon 11, welcome to the stream. Hello. And this bWorld ports a lot of games for MorphOS and applications, and I think that bPlayer is one of his original applications. I don't believe it is a port. And what you can do with that, bPlayer is able to play songs, a lot of formats of music, like MP3, OGG, Vorbis, mod files, XAMPP files, etc. It is minimalistic, as I said. You can click here and select some music, some songs. Let's select these songs. And I will select some mod files as well. The music plays. You have this graph here, and some information for the file. And you can, of course, move forward or back. Here is the sound, the volume level. And if you click here, you can see the playlist and say that, okay, I want to load this one, which is a mod, for example. You move the list up and down with the wheel of the mouse, and the one that is highlighted, if you click on that, it can play. And as you can see, it's pretty minimal. You can put it at the side. And if you click, double click on this area of the graph, that is able to go full screen. Although on my system, it goes always to the first screen, which is the screen of the laptop. So I can't show you that here, but you might be able to see it on my laptop at full screen, or not. Here it is. If you want to have something like that on your screen. So, and that's bPlayer. bWorld, as I said earlier, is doing a tremendous job with applications for MorphOS, especially the ones that are ported from other systems and are based on SDL. and you will see that a lot of games are ported by BWorld. So if you like his work and you want to say a thank you, please contact him, or if you want to support him further, he has the PayPal link usually in his applications, so you can support him. And the next one that I would like to show you, which is also exclusive for MorphOS, is, where is it? bePlayer, SoundBankster, and RNORadio. I had a little bit, I showed you this application a little bit in my last stream. It is able to stream from online radio stations. It has some default ones, for example, Nectarine or my loved, beloved, the Slay Radio, where you can listen to music from video games and retro games. And it has also some skins that you can change the way it looks, like that, which is more modern, if you prefer them to have them at the side of your screen and listen to your music. I prefer for this application to use the MIUI skin, the minimal MIUI skin, because it is the only one that has the ability to minimize it, and let it play at the back. Let me have a look at the chat. Falcon 11 says today better time as last time. You mean better time for the stream or something else? bePlayer is very good player and very low CPU load and new. Yeah. And it is actively maintained, so I recommend it a lot. Literally pretty simple, but out of the way and do what it is supposed to do. Yeah. Falcon 11 says, I supported already and I think I will give some money yet. Okay, that's good. That's good. It's always good, even if you are not able to donate money to a developer, spend some time to send him a message. Most of the developers have plenty of ways to be reached out, so spend some time to send him a message and tell them that you found the application that he creates quite useful, and say thank you. Most of the time the developers are contacted by users only if the user has a problem. But it's really motivating when you like something, tell them, I like that, it works well, it is useful for me, and I use it, and thank you for what you are doing. It's motivates the developers quite well, and I would recommend you to do so. Even if someone is not able to donate, this is a good way to show the appreciation of the work that they are doing. Liberal says, it's interesting that two out of three players are minimalistic, but they look all good. Yeah, and they are working, especially the last one. The players are great, those players, depending on what you want to do. I like RNO a lot, and because you have the ability to add your own radio stations, like the one that I have here, and you just load it and select another radio station, click play, and you listen to your music with a couple of clicks, And especially if you compare that experience with other operating systems, I don't think it's the same. I mean, try to do that with Windows or Mac. You have to wait for something to load a lot of seconds, and it's not that instant. And here with MorphOS, you click play and then you minimize the player and you are good to go and continue what you want to do. And you have your music at the background playing without any notifications and things like that. So, next one that I would like to show you is Amiga Amp 3. Unfortunately, Amiga Amp is not working on MorphOS, or at least I couldn't find any way to make it work. So if anyone of you has any insights on how it works or how can I make it work, please tell me, because okay, I have I can open the preferences and change things, but the actual application is not working. And I couldn't find any information on that on MorphZone or anywhere else. I think an older version of Amiga Amp, version 2.24, it was reported that it is working, but it's quite old version. In general, most of the applications that work well in Amiga 68K, classic Amigas, it will work on MorphOS pretty well. Falcon 11 says Amiga Amp 2.25 is working. Yeah, that's what I read and I found so far, but it is quite old version, I think. And a good example is EaglePlayer, but it is a little bit trivial to make it work at first. I have that working here. But before we start it, I would like to show you what someone needs to do to make it work for MorphOS. So I'm going to go to the, let me see if I can rename it. Because this installation work and I wouldn't like to destroy it in case something else happened. So I'm going to go here on my downloads and find the EaglePlayer 2.06 as I downloaded that from Aminet. You won't find that on MorphOS storage. It has an older version, 2.05. But let's see the 2.06. If you try to run EaglePlayer like that, actually EaglePlayer doesn't need to use the installation process, and it is something that it is mentioned on the documentation, so you can use it as it is. But if you try to use EaglePlayer like that with this icon on MorphOS, we are going to have some complaints, and you're going to see the CPU reaching 100% of usage all the time. So the recommended process is to go and let me show you here and delete the .info. So as soon as we do that, of course it doesn't have an icon right now. Falcon 11 says, does not matter if it is old, it play only MP3 and DOG. Yeah, new Amiga Amp, also more modules format, and for this we have a DPlayer. Exactly. Or the new bePlayer, exactly. So it is not necessary to have the Amiga Amp to use it in MorphOS, because other applications are doing exactly the same thing and maybe even better, because if those applications are native MorphOS application, it is better to use them than a 68K application. So the EaglePlayer, you can, since we deleted the icon, we can double click and that opens just fine, but you can't use it like it is right now. The thing that you need to do is to go to the engines, disable the 14-bit amplifier, enable AHI amplifier, and then go to show, select the mode, let's say 16-bit stereo, and click on global. Let's see if this is applied. Okay, global. Okay, so now it is applied on all channels, on all voices, sorry. And then the last thing that you need to do, at least on my system, it has the EaglePlayer is a little bit sensitive with the timing. Let's say, if you remember on my stream that I had for AmigaOS 4 and how EaglePlayer is able to work there, it has exactly the same issues. For my system, it works if I select the vBlank timing. But I think it depends on the screen resolution and the screen refresh frequency. So it might not work well on your system. So if you select timing vBlank and then go to save all the config, you can use EaglePlayer after that just fine. Let me load something. And let me load but of course it might not do that. So it seems like it tries to do something. Let's give it some time. Falcon 11 says yes, native is even better, like emulation. Yeah, it seems it freezed, but it doesn't give us CPU usage high. So what we need to do right now is, unfortunately, I'm going to reboot because you can't even start a second EaglePlayer if the one is already in the memory. I used it a lot. And I know that it works well. Maybe something in the configuration was not configured right, or because we saved the configuration but we didn't restart the application, it might not got the amplifier that needs to be used. So let's see again. Sometimes the old applications have this kind of issues. Let's start it. Let me check again the amplifier. So this is disabled, that is enabled, all is good here. The timing is vBlank. Okay, so it should work. Let's give it a try. So songs, see if you find a better configuration for your system. Let me stop that. A better configuration for your system based on the timing. For AmigaOS 4 to work, it needs a patch for the SIA, and of course, selecting the SIA, it works quite well, but it needs a patch. Here with the vblank, it is working fine. As I said, it might be this laptop, because I think it works in 60 Hz. So have that in mind. And that's EaglePlayer. And then I would like to show you DeliTracker, an old application. You will find it as well on MorphOS storage. You will find there a lot of files for DeliTracker. I think that you need just the DeliTracker that is DeliTracker 2.lzx and nothing else. You double click that. You click here, you select the music. Where is it? My home audio. And you have that playing just fine. This is a playlist, if you like it, if you want to use that. And create your own playlists and save them and load them whenever you want. Pro Tracker. Also, you have to check the DeliTracker if it has issues with the timing. Because as I said, with the EaglePlayer, it might, I think it plays a little bit slower than it should. Let's see a song that we heard earlier. I think it's a little bit slower, but yeah, based on your system, you have to see if it is playing better or not. Because these old applications tend to rely on the timing on the system. So, Leveler says, I did not see Pro Tracker in that drawer you have. Does MorphOS have Pro Tracker? Actually, I have some other trackers that I managed to test. There is DegiBooster, which is a commercial application, right? But there is a demo that you can find in MorphOS storage and at the website of DigiBooster, and you can find more information there. Let me load import and Pro Tracker, which is in general the mod files, I guess. But I might be wrong. So if I open something here and then say play song, DigiBooster is, as I said, commercial. You have to buy it, have all the features, but I think for replay mod files, the demo version is fine. I think that you are blocked to save, so to create your own music. And here it seems a little bit slower than it should, but it might be because of my... information about the instruments and of the blocks that are working, that are playing, and it's mostly meant to be an application to create your music and not just a player, a playback application. So yeah, that's DigiBooster. You can find it, let me show you the website. Right now, the DigiBooster is sold by APC TCP, which is the same company that is working with Amiga Future, the magazine and all this stuff. But the website of DigiBooster is digibooster.de. And there are versions for AmigaOS 3 and AmigaOS 4 as well. It is very good. So if you are into creating music, maybe it is the best solution there. It depends what you are doing, of course. As an Amiga based application, right? Because we will see some other trackers which are ported to MorphOS, and they might be more capable from DigiBooster. I don't know because I'm not into that. Falcon Leves says, I think ProTracker will not start, but we have, where is it? MilkyTracker or HivelyTracker, which we will see in a bit. And Kate says, Balderdas is using ProTracker player internally, works fine on MorphOS. Yeah. Yeah, it is working fine, yeah. And it has some other features like changing the theme, which is if you go to themes and select here the deep blue, which has a different view, of course, and it opens in a different screen. I don't know why. But you can move it again to ambient and you are there. And yeah, it works pretty well. Falcon Level says, why do you think slow? I might be wrong, Falcon, but I have the essence that it is a little bit slow. I have to check it with other mods that I know much better and compare these applications. But maybe it is just fine, and maybe the EaglePlayer plays a little bit faster than it should. Livelo says, I'm still learning and doing this in ProTracker. Don't want to switch yet, not until I learn more. And I am thinking to get my G4 laptop, so just exploring my options. Let me check again if ProTracker is available on MorphOS storage, because from my experience, the MorphOS storage, the people that are updating and putting all the applications there, most of the times they check them and they are sure that they are working quite well. So there are only icons, so I guess it is not working for MorphOS right now, and it's a matter of finding a way to make it work. Okay, guide, sorry about that. Thanks. We tend to spell things like we see that like we will do in English, and on the other side I am also Greek, so thanks very much, guide. Falcon Leva says module sounds slow, or DigiBooster MUI is slow. It might be that, as but I guess on my system, on this system, the PowerBook G4 that I have, it shouldn't be influenced by Magic User Interface. It shouldn't. But if I don't do the comparison, I can't be sure. It seems fine. it refreshes fine. I don't know if that influences the song. Let's try another one and here we have. I don't see that the size of the window influences the song, which is something that I have seen in I think HivelyTracker. Let's go to these applications. So we have HivelyTracker. It is better to use the latest version that is available on MorphOS storage. The previous one opens only in full screen and it has some issues. This one can open in a window mode. And let me load something and play. HivelyTracker is working quite well, but when I resized it to be bigger, like 1024 to 768, it tended to be slow, especially on the bars and the effects and things like that, and the scrolling of the pattern. So I keep it on 640 to 480, which is the default resolution, so it works quite well. Let me open another one. These applications, of course, this HivelyTracker and the MilkyTracker are applications that are ported from other systems, and they are usually based on SDL, so you have to have the SDL libraries installed, and otherwise they are not going to work. As you can see, MilkyTracker is also created by ported by BigWorld. And MilkyTracker has a lot of channels to play with, 22 for now, for this. Falcon Lever says, because I don't think that it's slow, maybe on real Amiga it's slow. Yeah, possibly, possibly. Now you can see here the MilkyTracker, it slows down because all these applications are created with SDL, so you have the extra resource need of the SDL. Okay. And let's see the next one that I'm having to show you, or I show you everything. Of course, we have seen Aminet Radio on the previous one, and the one that I left you to show you, the DAPlayer, is an interesting player that is plain enough. Let me add here some music. But it has the ability to show you the album art, the cover, while playing the songs. So if you have MP3 player songs, you can have the cover displayed here at the side, which is good to have. Of course it takes a lot of space. And sometimes this might not be something that you would like to have. And also it doesn't show here the information about the song, although I'm sure these files have that information in the ID tags. Libero says, thanks for showing this, George, very interesting. Yeah, and now it's time to, those are some applications that I tested and I know that are working well. How about seeing some other applications that I downloaded and see if we can install them here in my MorphOS and see if they are working. Guide says, did you show Jukebox already, which is nice for reggae compatible media? Jukebox, is this something that I can find on MorphOS storage? I might miss that. Let me have a look. Or yeah, as Guide said, please propose other applications that I missed, and they might be your the applications that you like to use, and we can see them here. And if I go to audio, or let's search about that. Jukebox. Jukebox Adder, Jukebox Vom. Oh no, those are all scripts. It is included with MorphOS. Right. But the Jukebox is for audio CDs or not? No, I don't have that here. There is Flacapella, which is for audio CDs, to grab audio CDs. And Guide, I think I missed that. In utilities. Ah, okay, yeah. This is for it. Okay, let's see if we can play some MP3s. Yeah, absolutely, it works fine. And what kind of formats it supports. I think we have seen that when at the stream, at the second stream, that we have seen the tools, and it was created by Binary Riot. Yeah. And one Dubok. Yeah. Let's see if it's open. No, MP3s only are by default selected. So there you have. You can have this Jukebox as well, which is nice, with a very nice icon. And it shows the notifications at the top right, just fine. Yeah, to be honest, I haven't used it, and it looks pretty good. That's why there is those scripts, they use Jukebox as a player, right? Okay. Yeah. Guide says, never liked the tools, applications, utilities mix-up. Yeah, the way that I distinguish them is like tools are things that are closer to the system. Utilities are things like they are useful for people to do something, but they are not required for your operating system. And applications, usually you could say that are applications that come as contribution by third developers, maybe. Even if some of those developers are part of the MorphOS team, but that's something that it is happening with AmigaOS as well, AmigaOS 3 and AmigaOS 4. So the way that I distinguish, I have them in my mind and distinguish them is like that. I don't know if it makes sense, but instead of having everything in the same bucket, maybe it is useful to have that like that, categorized like that. So let's see some other applications. As I said, most of the 68K applications should work well. So I have some of them here to test. Let me find the first one that I would like to show you. Where is it? Let's see the SoundFX. SoundFX is a very nice application that unfortunately is not developed anymore. And let me create here a drawer, SoundFX. That's mostly for loading sound files and convert them or process them in a way to cut parts and think, or apply some filters. And it is only 68K. You can find all the files at the at the Morpho storage. Also, we have seen that running well on AmigaOS 4, but let's see how it works on MorphOS as well. Okay, so install. Here it is. Okay, install for real, sound effects. Okay, continue. Plus there's a destination and drawer called SFX will be automatically generated. Great. So we are going to install it in applications, music here. Protein fonts. Let's choose standard. Okay. Sound effects now you can use the identify library, but it is not installed or too old. Continue. And let's see what happens. Error, unknown command is a fatal error. Okay. Okay. So it started, it installed, but something tried to open in Workbench. Let's see how it goes. Livelo says, that's why I install everything on different partition on Amiga MG and Classic. I can keep track of stuff easier and keep installation clean. Yeah, and that's a good practice if you have different setups on the same machine with different versions of the operating system. And you have everything in a separated partition and you can make them work just fine. So let's have a look on sound effects. Here it is. Let's see if Everything is here. Okay, let's try it. It will crash, I know that it will crash. Or, okay. Okay, it doesn't seem to work. So let's see what if we can debug it and see why it doesn't work. Snoopium, sound effects. It seems that there's no problem. Let's have a look on its icon. And we have a big crash. Let's reboot. Aris Amiga says, "Woo, debugging." Yeah, not that kind of debugging, not debugging the code, but trying to figure out what is wrong. It's a good way to learn your system. And in such a situation, we have a few tools that we can use and see if an application requires some libraries or some other objects, so we can provide them. And let's see what we can find here. For example, applications like SnoopDos, Snoopium is very good for this thing. And I wish I had them in other systems as well. And I wouldn't need to look in huge log files to find information about why something is not working. So let's give it a try again. Now we get much more information. Numeric string MCC. As you can see, it misses this library. This library, okay. Oh no, this is for the, okay, let me clear that. Let me try that again. Okay, now it starts. Weird, of course. So sound effects, I think at the website of sound effects there is also a key available, so you can have all the features able to be used. And you can load from the menu at the top. You can load files, audio files like AIFF. I think you can load MP3s, but on AmigaOS 4, this loader for MP3 files is a little bit buggy. You can load the first time the audio, but if you try to load another one, it crashes. I don't know if this is going to happen here again as well, but we can try it. And you have here the graph of the sound. And also you can do different things like, let me remember, we have here, you can select Ahi. You can replay it, of course. You can select a section which you want to cut or do some changes. It is, of course, for processing sound and even a record sound from, I don't know, from your microphone or something like that. Emek, welcome to the stream. Glad you're here. And also you can analyze the sound from, where is it? Ah, okay, because this is a demo version, doesn't have everything. Let me see if I can find something here. Analyze Specs3D. Let's try that and see what we get. An analysis for the sound that we have, which is, it has a lot of analysis and tools and a lot of filters. I think that is one of the most complete applications for sound for Amiga. And if you are into that, it it deserves to give it a try and see how it works on your system, and if you can use it for making your music or doing some stuff with your MorphOS. So it works. You can change the. It has the configuration for the GUI. You can change the fonts and the colors to whatever you like. So it is more viewable. Let's see how it looks after that. Much better than previously. Of course, this application requires RTG support for the graphics card, so it works quite well because it doesn't require for the extra chipsets of the Amiga. Let's see if it will crash if we load once. If we load one more MP3, I'm curious. Or if it is only something that has to do with Amiga OS4. Okay, it works fine. It seems to work fine. Of course, remember to select here that you want to use AHI. Otherwise, you will not be able to replay the audio. And yeah, that's it from me today. There are a lot of applications out there that you could use for manipulating the audio files that you might have. I was looking for the one more application that I would like to show you, but I don't remember if I downloaded that. Let me have a look. No, I don't see that. If you give me a moment, I would like to download it. Which is also an 68K application, and I think that is one of the applications that someone who would like to make music on Amiga is that would be quite useful to use. This is at editors, I think, and no, let me find it. Where is it? No. Sequencer editor mix players, don't think so. Mix, maybe it is here. No. Tracker players. Anyway, maybe we will see it on a next one of the next streams, and we can have a look on that. So for today, that's mostly the applications that I wanted to show you. Of course, don't forget the infinite player, the IMP3. It gets updates every week, and is working quite well on MorphOS. And if you like that application that you can use to stream mod files and listen to music on your MorphOS machine, please try this out, and please support the developer so he can bring us more updates in the future. That's all I would like to show you today. I hope you enjoyed the stream. I hope you found something useful. And before we close, I would like to thank you all for being here and taking the time to listen to me rambling here and showing all these applications. The next streams are going to be pretty much similar. We are going to see other applications. Maybe for the next stream, we are going to see graphics or office applications. We will see what comes into my head and what will be interesting for you to have a look. I'd like to thank you again, all of you, for being here, because without you, it wouldn't make sense for me to do all the live streams. And especially I would like to thank all my supporters at the Ko-fi page that I have, and my monthly supporters who helped me to do all the things that I'm doing, who is Breed, Christopher White, Daniel Zedlika, Emek, and Livelord, who believe in my in the things that I'm working, like the open source applications and the videos that I'm creating here. And about the applications, have in mind that I plan to release a newer version of iGame the following days, so have that in mind. I would like also to mention that every month, at the end of every month, 50% of the donations that I get at the Ko-fi page that I have from my supporters are donated back to the Amiga community and to other developers that bring Amiga software or support websites or other projects for Amiga and for the Amiga community. So by donating to me, you also support other people in our small community. And yeah, I would like to thank you all for that. Falcon Lever says, last stream about AIO streams is working in my MorphOS PowerBook G4. In some, it is good. Okay, that's great. That's great, Falcon. I'm glad it is working. I use mPlayer 1.4, pretty good. That's awesome. I hope you have fun with that. And in case something goes wrong and breaks, please give me a shout. Thanks everyone again for being here. Glad I have you all in my stream. Have a great weekend and take care. Bye-bye.